Well, hello everyone. This is Carrie Beck with How to Homeschool My Child. I'm getting the hang of Facebook. They have the little red live button when I think it's time to go. So I'm trying to follow the red button. Anyway, today I'm here to talk to you because it's the second week of Advent. And so I'm going to talk to you a little bit about peace. That is what last week it was about hope. I guess I should have put that link. But if you look at our media and videos, you can see that video last week about hope. Hope is not wishing something. Hope is a confident expectation in the Bible. And that is a confident expectation in Jesus Christ. And so you can go listen to that. But today we're going to talk about peace. I put up a blog post on Sunday about peace, and I shared a couple verses from John about God. He first says that in this world we will have trouble, but I have overcome the world. And that's true. God has overcome death and sin and all of those things. But he also says that I am leaving this world, but I am leaving you and I'm going to give you peace. Not as the world gives you peace, but I'm going to give you my peace. And so let's talk for a few minutes just about what is peace in God's eyes. Now, I know I'm a few minutes earlier than 1 o'clock, but I have to be somewhere at 1, so I was trying to sneak this in. All right, let's look at three verses on peace. The first one is Philippians 4, 6, and 7. It's a little bit long. I'm going to read the whole thing, and then we're going to talk about it for a few minutes. It says, "Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to all men. The Lord is near." And here's the part. So there's one thing. We need to be rejoicing, and I think that will bring us peace. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. So let's see the result of this at the end of this section of these verses, the last thing, and the peace of God. He will give that to you. It'll guard your heart. It'll guard your mind when all the world seems to be falling apart. And, I meant to print this out, but let me just tell you, it was a phrase. And I think too often we think that peace is the absence of conflict. Peace is really the presence of Jesus. So it's not the absence of conflict, it's the presence of Jesus. Now, let's look at what we need to be able to have peace. First, rejoice in the Lord. We need to have joy. We need to choose joy. The next one is don't be anxious about anything. Don't be worried. Don't be concerned because you need to go to God in prayer. In everything, you need to pray, and you pray to God because He's the one. We always need to be turning to God, and when we turn to God, that is when we are going to have real peace. Now, the rest of the world can be falling apart. There can be tension in your family. There can be conflict, and you can still have peace even when there is conflict and tension in your home, in your neighborhood, in your business, your home school or your church or whatever. Peace does not come from it is not a absence of conflict or tension. So rejoice, don't be anxious in everything, pray to God about it. And then the last one, always be thankful. That's the thing. We need to always have an attitude of thanking God. And all of these things take our eyes off of us, off of our problems, and we go to God. And we just keep our eyes focused on Him. And really, the peace that He gives is beyond any understanding, just like it says here in Philippians 4, 7. So Philippians 4, 6, and 7 is the first set of verses. The next one is Colossians 3, 13 and through 15. It's one of my favorite verses. And my son actually posted on his Instagram a couple days ago, and he never posts anything on Instagram. Hey, Bill, glad you're here. Thank you for your kind words. So let me read Colossians 3, 13 to 15, and then we'll talk a little bit more about other things that have to do with peace. Make allowance for each other's faults and forgive anyone who offends you. Ouch, that's sort of hard. Forgive anyone that gives me offense, but listen to the next part. Remember, the Lord forgave you, and so we must forgive others. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds us together in perfect harmony. There we have some peace ideas there. And let the peace that comes from Christ rule in our hearts, for as members of one body, we are called to live in peace and always be thankful. So let's sort of look at this. The first thing is we need to have an attitude of taking off anything that someone offends us, and we need to forgive them. This is not a talk on forgiveness, it's a talk on peace. And I have other ones on forgiveness, and you can watch those. But we do need to forgive, not because we're just supposed to. If God can forgive me for my sins, I need to forgive others. So we need to make allowance for each other's faults. And then, because God forgave us, we need to clothe ourselves. We need to put on love on a regular basis. What is love? Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or rude or boastful or proud. It does not keep a record of wrong, and it does not get angry or irritable. Those are some things that love is. Love never gives up, never loses faith, always hopes, and endures through every circumstance because God's love never fails. God is saying that is how we need to live our life. If we are patient and kind, I believe God's going to give us the peace that we need. That verse, the verses I just shared are from 1 Corinthians 13, all about love, and it's some verses that I pray every single morning for our family. So we need to forgive, we need to put on love, and that is what binds us together in harmony. Harmony is like getting along and having peace with each other. And so we need to put on love so that we can have peace. If we're patient and kind with others and we're not demanding our own way, then we can have peace with others. And then he says, and let the peace that comes from Christ rule in our hearts. And so again, our peace doesn't come from our situation. It's not a lack of conflict. It's not a lack of tension. It is Jesus Christ. Let the peace that comes from Christ rule in our hearts. Is Christ in your heart? Is he the one that's most important? And it says, for as members of one body, talking about the church around the whole world, not just a little local church, we are called to live in peace. God calls us to live in peace and to always be thankful. Do you hear some similarities? Philippians 4, Colossians 3, to always be thankful, to go to God, to keep our eyes focused on God, and to love as well. So that's Colossians 3, 13 through 15. And then the last verse I want to read to you is another one of my daily prayers, Ephesians 6, 15. And it's a part of the armor of God. And one of the pieces of the armor is with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. We need to walk in peace every day. And when I started praying the armor of God, one of the ways I would pray peace is I would say, God, would you just have our family walk in peace with you? Peace with ourselves and peace with each other. Again, that doesn't mean there's a lack of conflict. That just means that we are going to have peace with God first. Then we need to have peace within ourselves and accept God's forgiveness. And then we're going to have peace with others. I believe that when we put on the shoes of peace, the armor, the shoes of peace, the boots of peace, we will walk in peace. And then we are truly spreading the peace of God because people will see us as something different. My sister-in-law was here right on the other side of the wall a couple months ago, and we were talking about a family member that we believe was really struggling. And I was talking about how sometimes we can tell whether someone's got peace in their hearts, whether they have light in their eyes. And I was like, I just don't see that light. And she looked at me, and she goes, yes, but you have light in your eyes, even after all the things that you have gone through the last 4 years. I was like, oh, I know I have light in my eyes because I have peace here and because my eyes stay focused on Jesus most of the time. I am not perfect. And yes, I get selfish and want my own way. And even at Christmas time, I'm like, oh, kids, can't we celebrate? I don't say this to them. Can't we celebrate Christmas at another time of the day? Do we really have to do it at lunchtime? But I was like, zip it up. Just be glad that we're all going to be together. So Philippians 4, 6, and 7, God's peace will guard our hearts and minds. Colossians 3, 13, 15, we are called to live in peace with Christ ruling in our hearts. And then Ephesians 6, 15, we need to be walking in peace, those boots of peace with God, with ourselves, and with each other. There's so much more I could share. I will be sharing through the week a daily verse. Each day I'll post probably in the afternoon a verse about peace, and that will have some questions, and that will give you an opportunity to read the verse at dinner time and then maybe talk about it since this week of Advent is all about peace. So, Bill, thanks for being here and thanks for everyone else. Not everyone left comments. I could see numbers popping in and out and all. So I appreciate this. If y'all have any questions, other verses you want to share, or comments, please leave a comment there. I did leave the the blog post on peace for this week as well. And that has some other stuff that you can consider. I am Carrie Beck with How to Homeschool My Child. I forgot. Tomorrow I will be back and we're going to do Christmas science experiments. I will demonstrate that. And then on Thursday I will be back. I'll be talking about St. Lucia's Day, which is December 13th. And I believe that is Sunday. And so I'll be talking about some activities you can do with St. Lucia's Day. Anyway, thanks so much for spending time with me. I am Carrie Beck with How to Homeschool My Child. Y'all have a great day.